What's up, Timekeeper? It's me, Tom Gamer, here, bringing the next part of our E3 2018 coverage with Bethesda's E3 showcase presented by, of course, Bethesda, as you know it. So this one was one of the conferences I was waiting for the most, besides the Sony one. And believe me, I was really surprised by the conference. They showed us a couple of new modes for some of the games that are already out, a couple new games and games to come in the future. So of course, in this video, I'll be talking about some of my favorite moments. I'm not going step by step of the conference. I'm basically just talking about my favorite parts of the conference, the best announcements or stuff that they showed on the conference. So without further ado, let's just jump right in. So the first game they started off with was Rage 2, with a nice introduction of Andrew WK, which was kind of weird for starting a conference off. It's more of a passé trend that he used to do in the past, not Bethesda necessarily, but other press conference. But we did get a lot more info on Rage 2, including a lot of gameplay, which you can go see the trailer on YouTube. Basically, they introduces us to the main character, named Walker, which is one of the last rangers in the world of Rage 2. He's the main protagonist, which you're gonna help out and do all the things you do usually in Rage. I don't remember necessarily if I remember playing the original Rage, and I feel if I remember, Rage was more of a car game. I don't remember getting out of the car that much. So there's a lot of cool gameplay that was shown, like a lot of cool mechanics, like cool weapons, cool modifiers. There was one item that was like a sort of what seemed like a gravity grenade that just pulled everything in the center, and then you could kill them, and different types of grenade and deploy items you can deploy, and a lot of stuff looked interesting. The mission they were presenting looked very interesting, so I'll let you guys go check that trailer out. So far, the only announcement date we have for Rage 2 is spring 2019, so we'll definitely have to check out when that gets there. I don't know what the fervor is about Rage 2. I don't know how people are receiving it. I know a lot of people at the beginning, before they showed the gameplay this year at E3, were not like super hyped for the game, because the first Rage wasn't like that all of a success as much. But the tone is completely different this time around. It's a lot more colorful, and it's not as, I think drab is the right word here, sort of unicolored. I don't know if that's an actual word, but it doesn't. It's not all brown and all the same colors. It seemed there's a lot more life to the game compared to what I remember playing in the first Rage. And of course, this game is made by id and Avalanche Studios, so we'll definitely keep an eye out for that when that comes out next year. So another new game that they announced at this year at the conference, I heard some people mentioning it a couple of times, but I don't think they were actually thinking they were going to show it. But they announced Doom Eternal, which they did mention was a sequel to Doom, the new entity in the franchise from Bethesda. So this time around, they have explained that there's, like, I think two times the enemy type in the game. It takes place on Earth. Apparently, that was a big demand of the fans of the game, of the original, not the original, but the first iteration of the new generation of the game. And hopefully, everybody's going to enjoy it. It's just a lot more killing, a lot more of the Doom guy, pretty much. So hopefully you guys were interested in that. Hopefully we'll get to see new mechanics and things that won't necessarily unbalance the world, because I did the biggest critique when from the first game, well, it wasn't a critique, but the biggest applaud for the last game was that the last game really took a lot of features from the original Doom, and that's why people enjoyed that game so much. Hopefully they're able to continue in that line of thought, or in that line of gaming, and go from there. Our next announcement we have from Bethesda is from Wolfenstein Universe. So I know a lot of people were happy after Wolfenstein the New Colossus, or Wolfenstein 2, or whatever you want to call it. A lot of people enjoyed that game. It was a nice continuation from the, once again, Wolfenstein the new iteration of the game. So we have a new DLC, which is Youngblood DLC, which is a co-op mission from, it takes place in the Paris, if I remember, in the 1980s, with BJ's twin daughters, which is kind of weird. I never finished the game, so I don't know if that's something in something in the end game of Wolfenstein the New Colossus. So hopefully you guys will check that out. That's one of the things they announced. And then of course they were also talking about a new VR experience for Wolfenstein, which is called Cyberpilot, which I don't remember all the info, but apparently it's going to be a lot of a puzzle. I think they were saying it was going to be a puzzle type thing. I'm not 100% sure. Definitely go check out the trailer for that over at the Bethesda YouTube page for more information with VR, because VR is still a thing that's going on. I wish I had more info and more grasp of VR, but it's just something I can't personally buy. It's just too expensive. And I don't have the rig, and I don't want to buy the PS4 one right now. So we'll definitely have to see more of that if this is coming to PS4 version. I don't know yet. They didn't have a lot of info on the Cyber Pilot one. All right, the Big Mac Daddy next in the conference, which I was waiting for a lot. This was, if you've been to this channel a lot, you know that Fallout is one of my favorite games of all time. That it for me, this stands next to Grand Theft Auto and multiple other games that I can't live without every time they announce it. And Fallout 76 is definitely going to be one of them. I heard a lot of critiques about about people complaining about it being online and stuff like that. But Todd Howard from Bethesda did explain a lot about the game. So first off, of course, they started off talking about it being the prequel. It being 25 years after the bombs fell. So you start off where you get out of the vault on Reclamation Day. Basically, you're going off for the first time. You're one of the first people out of the wasteland. There's no bases. There's no nothing. So some of the cool information that they showed for Fallout 76 is it's going to be 4 times the size of Fallout 4, which I don't know how the hell they're going to do that. It has 6 different biospheres, so this game is going to be pretty big. There's a lot of greenery in the game, a lot of trees that seem like they weren't affected by the Fallout. There's a lot of, it takes place in the hills of West Virginia, which is another cool place that we've never been to. I can't wait to see what that's going to be all about, because I don't know a lot about the lore of West Virginia, so we'll definitely have to get more information as the game comes out. There's a lot of cool stuff that they did show at the Xbox press conference, and they did show a lot at the Bethesda press conference. So a lot of unexplored land, I think I already mentioned that. A lot of new enemies they mentioned, some flying enemies, like almost what it made me thought right away was like a dragon in Skyrim, but now you're getting a, don't remember exactly the names of the enemy, definitely go check out the trailer for that. But huge flying enemies, big structures, and then also we also get power armors back, which one of my questions is, I hope that since this is a co-op game, always online game also, what I forgot to mention, is I hope we do see power armor in some of the trailer, where you see it, basically the way you see it in Fallout 4, it looks about the same. I really hope that the power armor are not scarce, like, because since you're playing with our player, that's a lot more difficult to get a power armor. I just hope it's as easy as it was in Fallout 4. The way they were explaining the online mode is you won't have 100 players in the game. It's about a dozen or so players in the game, which you can team up with about, make team of 4 if I saw correctly from what we can assume from looking at the trailer. There's no permadeath, so that's one big complaint a lot of people were worried about, because they were saying it's a survival game like Rust or whatever those type of games, which Todd did mention in a funny way, where it's not a hardcore survival, it's a softcore survival. So no permadeath, it's completely online. There's going to be base building instead of doing the same thing they did in Fallout 4, where there was stationary areas where you can do base building. This time around, it's a portable workbench, basically, that you can put anywhere you want, bring anywhere you want with you, and then just put it down, build anything you want. But of course, it is destructible by other enemies, big monsters, or anything that comes across your base. So there will be some base defending and stuff like that, but it didn't seem like it was the main focus. They did say that this game can be completely played solo. That I really hope. They were talking today, actually, in an interview from, I think they were over at YouTube. They were doing an interview with Todd Howard. Jeff Keighley was doing an interview, and they were saying that you will be able to do private servers, and if you want to play alone on a private server, that's up to you. You can do that. It won't be available on launch, so that's the little thing they mentioned, that it wasn't going to be available on launch. So we're gonna have to keep an eye out on that. Another cool little feature they were talking about too is there's also bombs in the game. So the power of the atom, the way they were explaining it, where you can, if you find all the correct keys to activate nuclear bombs, you can actually launch nuclear bombs in areas anywhere on the map to kill neighbors or kill monsters or stuff like that. And just a big ass nuclear blast happens in that area. And also, while, of course, there's going to be a radiation time when that nuclear blast, and you're going to be able to find special items, rare items and stuff like that, that you won't be able to find without the nuclear bombs. Also, more information, there also is a beta so far. The beta seems to be only available to people that pre-order the game, so definitely go check out. There wasn't a date announced for the beta, but there was a release date, though, which is pretty awesome. It's on November 14, 2018, so that's pretty soon. Once again, continuing in the tradition of Fallout 4, and that's pretty much it for the information I was able to gather, there's a lot more people explaining it going in depth. I might talk about it more a bit later there, but some of the worries I was thinking about was, of course, I mentioned the power armors. One thing is, are we able to play non-PvP servers where enemies can't kill each other? That would be pretty cool. And also, I was thinking, I hope there's no premium currency. That would be one thing I think would actually ruin the game experience. If you have, like, of course, I'm not talking about Creation Club where it is premium mods, but those, we're talking about mods, but they weren't going to be available right away because they want to tweak the servers and tweak the online portion of the game before they start doing that. And I think the way he was mentioning is that the mods will only be available on private servers and not in the general games where anywhere you're playing with anybody, random people in the world. So that, at least there's that it keeps it even. Like I was mentioning, I hope there's no premium currency. I think this would, if people, because I don't want it to be exactly like ESO, where ESO, there's so many customization things that's going on. The world's like almost too big for some reason. Every time I go in there, one thing I like about open worlds is I like being overwhelmed. And ESO, I feel like I get too much overwhelmed. There's too much things to do. I just hope that Fallout 76 doesn't go in that trajectory. Another one of my worries that I had is I was afraid that enemies were going to be a lot tougher to try to kill, like a Division sort of, where the game's online and you're if you're level 15, there is level, monsters do have level now too. I did notice that from when their name pops up, there is a level to it. But I just hope that it's not a, like, if I'm trying to kill another player, it's not going to be, well, not necessarily a player, but like if I'm killing another human, it's not going to take him as many shots as a Deathclaw right now in Fallout 4, right? Yes. So I just hope it's well balanced in the tradition of Fallout 4, normal Fallout games, and that it keeps going in that trajectory. So I'm really hyped for Fallout 4. I've seen some people that were like, oh, it's online, blah, blah, blah. Even still, after the press conference, some people weren't convinced. I'm convinced I'm going to be playing it either solo or with you guys on in the community or with my friends or brother or whatever who wants to play with me. I just hope, like, oh, and also one thing I forgot is all the things you do go from, it's not server locked. So everything you do can go, it follows you all the time. Like I mentioned earlier, there's no permadeath, so you don't lose everything when you die. So that's the cool things. Definitely going to keep my eye out for more Fallout information, because this is going to be pretty sick once it comes out. I'm going to leave it there for Fallout, because I could keep going on for an hour still only on Fallout itself. The next couple of things, I'm just going to go quick mentions because they were cool, but there isn't a lot of information. The two last big things that they kept for the end of the conference was Starfield, which is a new IP they announced. A lot of people were floating that name around for a while, but they finally decided to just, like, oh, it's here, it exists. Not yet, though. And then they also announced Elder Scrolls 6, which the way they were talking about, the game will be out after Starfield. So we're not going to see, these are next generation games. These are going to be like PlayStation 5 or Xbox, whatever they're going to call it. So these are not games that are coming out right now. You still have a few years to wait for these games. I think that's why they kept it at the end there, just to be like, hey, we still have these games. I know you guys have been asking for these games, but they are coming eventually, but not just yet. So hopefully you guys enjoyed my coverage of my favorite moments of Bethesda's E3 showcase. This was a very good showcase. Of course, I'm going to keep going with the PlayStation conference in the next video, hopefully the next video, and then Ubisoft after that to finish it off. Hopefully you guys enjoying the announcement. These are some of my favorite. I'm always excited to see what the studios are bringing every year, especially Bethesda and Sony. Well, since we're doing Bethesda, we're going to talk about Bethesda. Bethesda has brought a lot of cool stuff, a lot of add-ons to their present games. It was a solid showcase. A lot of people were, I don't know why every year people concentrate, give notes on the conferences from Cringe Factor 2, which is weird, because you're going to get cringe because people, these guys work in an office most of the day in front of a computer, so they're not used to talking to 1,000+ people at a time. They did have a cool stage layout too. One thing I'll mention, I know I'm jumping a bit back and forth, the stage layout was pretty cool. Todd Howard was using a lot of the stage, which was pretty fun. I don't know why I'm mentioning that, just something I noticed while he was talking. But all in all, I really enjoyed the press conference. A lot of game talk to me. These games are a lot in my wheelhouse of games I like to play, and hopefully they're in your wheelhouse too, and hopefully you guys are going to be excited as me to play Fallout 76. It's something I'm going to be playing a lot. I feel like this is going to be a lot of my attention, discovering this whole world. Already Fallout 4 has taken me for, took me forever to discover everything, and I'm still, right to this day, when they announced Fallout 76, I just opened it up again, and I found new stuff. I hadn't finished Far Harbor, but even in the Commonwealth, I found new locations I've never found for some reason, odd reasons, where they were right there and I never saw them, which was pretty cool. So there's always something. I can just imagine four times bigger than Fallout 4. This is going to be crazy. I'm expecting a lot more underground stuff, a lot more, hopefully a lot more vaults, because this is always the first thing I do when I'm playing Fallout games. I try to find all the vaults in the map so I can explore and find more story, because that's my biggest interest, is what they were doing with the vaults, the experiments, especially Vault 76, which is just a plain of the mill one that's supposed to work exactly the way it's supposed to. So that's pretty interesting. Hopefully there's a lot of computers, terminals we're going to be able to hack and check out and go from there. So hopefully you guys enjoyed. Hit the like button, subscribe channel, leave a comment below what you enjoyed of the Bethesda showcase. What's your favorite part? What's your worst part? What's the cringiest part of the showcase? And leave a comment below, anything I could change the way I'm covering the press conference. Of course, stay nice as always. You don't need to be mean. You just say, hey, don't speak too much. Hey, script your stuff better. I don't script. I'm just actually going off the cuff when I'm doing this, if you haven't noticed for some reason. And of course, follow me everywhere, MeTimeGamer, Twitter, Twitch, Facebook, Instagram, and right here, youtube.com/MeTimeGamer, where I post a new video every day of the week, Monday to Friday, 3 p.m. Eastern Time. So thank you so much, guys, for watching. Now we'll see you next video. Keep on keeping on.